This is a comparison of safety cutters for rope bondage, shibari, kinbaku, or any other name you want to go by. There have been two elimination rounds prior to this test, all of which tested safety shears specifically. One of those tests was for shears from BDSM and rope benders. The best shear out of that was the S&M shears here. And then I did a second test where I compared vanilla shears such as ADC, Prestige, North American Rescue, things like that, well-known brands, and I selected the best from those. S&M was tested alongside of those. The best mid-range shear that I found was the Klaus shears, as long as it holds consistent model to model. The Klaus shears, in my selection, from what I had, performed the best. This is probably only going to be part one in the kind of pursuit of learning this. I've learned that shears are more than just their cutting power, and there's some reasons why I now favor particularly a pair of cutters that I had never expected myself to enjoy as much as I did. And those kinds of features are not necessarily pulled the best through just cutting performance. I've also made one elimination from this test specifically, which is the Leatherman Raptors, on the basis simply that my pair is faulty. I've gone through two pair, they've both been faulty. I've stated in another video that I think there's performance and control issues in Leatherman regarding this line. I've also made the point in that same video that these, although I've seen them cut well, and they do cut very well, they cut like a high-end shear, they don't cut better than the X shear in any video that I've ever seen, and the X shears are cheaper. And I go more into detail about that, but essentially, there's really no reason to buy the Leatherman Raptors. They're just a fairly gimmicky tool. So I've eliminated them. I'm going to make one more elimination from this. Just like with the safety shear videos, all of these have been tested with at least two cuts. Some of them with replaceable blades, such as the Trilobite and the Jackknife. I've gone through some spare blades, and I've tested them extensively more, so I know how they cut. I've also had the opportunity to see the one pair here, this pair. This I bought because I needed to make a shipping minimum, actually, or a purchase minimum. These cut bad enough that I'm just going to go ahead and eliminate them here. So that's one more elimination. Remaining for this test, and this is only a test of cutting power, ability to cut through various ropes. Those ropes I have here, I'll go over them in a minute. The shears that I have remaining are the Klaus shears, the X shears, the Kretzer Safety Boy Robins. This is called the Gerber Vital Zip, and a big reason why this one is here is because it is the successor of an old BDSM favorite, which was the, I think it's called the Gerber Easy Cutter, or the Gerber Easy Knife, something to that degree. It was a much smaller version, but with the same cutting element. The Jack Knife, I think this is the Jack Safety Knife, the Ontario Knife Company ASEC Cutter. This is called the Trilobite Easy Cut, if I believe, or you could search for Trilobite. This is the Benchmade Model 8, I believe, and this is the Boker Rescom. These two are very well known in the BDSM community, and there's some back and forth about which one's better, and I confess my quick answer right now, if you want to hear it, is that I'm not convinced that one is better than the other anyway. So the rope that we've got for this video is going to be cotton, paracord to test for smaller diameter ropes, nylon, Kevlar. These three are all quarter inch, so quarter inch Kevlar. This is 8mm hemp, flax hemp specifically, from Twisted Monk, popular one, so it's the one I'm testing. This is 8mm posh, so your typical posh, and then upsize it. This is very large for what it is, quarter inch am steel. I'm actually going to put it on the other side of this rope. This is half-inch regatta braid. Regatta braid is still a nylon, to my knowledge. It's just pure nylon, just a relatively strong braid that gives it some stiffness, lack of stretch. The reason some other ropes are not in here is just to make this test a little bit shorter. It's still going to be a long video. Jute, linen, hemp, MFP, a host of different materials were all taken out because I know that they are easier to cut than these. So we expect those to be cuttable, even with, as I showed in some of the cheaper shears tests, even some of the cheaper shears can cut those pretty consistently. So we'll eliminate them just for specific for some time efficiency. I'm going to go ahead and get into the test, and I'm going to kind of just discuss as I kind of go along to make it a little bit less boring as watching this. I've actually just recently tested this. I'll go ahead and test these again. Cotton, these are the Klaus shears. I should hold it down. At this point in the test, I kind of expect them to be able to cut it without holding tension. So I might do that as a difference. Two, my standard for this test is that all of these shears should be able to cut with one cut, as long as it is less than 6 millimeter diameter or below. Kevlar is a good kind of exception because it's hard to cut. And so is Amsteel. Amsteel is kind of a stretch goal, as Amsteel is very difficult to cut. So holding this loosely, these knives, these shears perform a little bit worse. They are, I also suspect they're shears that can be dulled pretty quickly, given that they're less expensive. And these may be going dull from the last test, unfortunately. These have gone through an elimination round. Still, that video stands, so I can reference it for how they did. These are going to fail the Amsteel test just like they did last time. So they cut, they don't cut, they don't do half bad. Under tension, under rope tension, what were some of the worst performing ones? Kevlar, if you put it under tension, I actually think these did much better in the elimination round. These may be going dull quickly, and unfortunately that's just a side effect of, you know, the shear material. These will, for a budget shear, I'm not totally upset with these. I do feel like they're going bad on me pretty quickly. X Shear, by X Shear, brand and name. They only make one product to my knowledge. These are $30 to $40, I think. It's been a while since I've gone over the prices. Pass. Let me, they're stiffer off the top of my head. I can tell they're stiffer. Goes through Kevlar fine. That, I've probably used these more than most of the shears, so they've been through some work. These larger diameter, what is actually happening is this is the fibers are splaying out because the rope isn't secured. Regatta braid is a very, or this half inch regatta braid is a very thick rope. Amsteel. I'm not going to call that a fail, but it still takes time. Amsteel is, I think there may only be one shears that passes the Amsteel test with flying colors. Let me clear this out. And we'll rearrange them as we go. Crutcher, Safety Boy Robbins. These are actually a very, like, old brand. These have been around for decades. They're heavy as hell. Big shears. I'm not going to go in order. I'm just going to whack them. I know these shears well enough to know the result of this. That's just a really big rope right there. Okay. So this is a long story short. This is a pure cutting power. You're not going to beat this, I don't think. Gerber Vital Zip. Let's just do it. It's an interesting knife. You have to kind of pull it. This is into this kind of group of knives here. It's a razor blade or some similar component, a utility blade, and you're dragging it along. So it's kind of a it's more like a common knife. Just protected. Now Kevlar, it had a hard time on, and that's because Kevlar is resistant to knife-like cutting. It's, if you're using Kevlar, you probably don't want to use that. You want to use shears. Shears are going to be able to cut it more consistently. And this is such a large rope. and cutting right over the other ones really makes a mess. Okay. Eventually gets it, more or less. It's not really a pass on that. Am steel. That was much better than I expected. I don't think I've tested those very... I think I've only done the two tests, the two goat cut. So that's the Gerber, the Jack safety knife. Jack has a very large handle if you needed to like get up and reach it. This is, I believe, made for parachute people, for reaching parachute lines. It is same kind of concept. It's got double blades, and these blades cross each other. I'm going to have a hard time seeing that, but they cross each other. I'm going to take a moment to open the blinds because it's getting darker. The sun is setting. Camera will perform better that way. So we're going to start with the cotton. Very good. Nice, easy, smooth. I should talk a little bit. It's cutting through without a lot of pressure. Thinner diameter, goes through fine. So we've gotten these. I don't think I've done Kevlar yet. It actually goes through Kevlar really well. It still essentially captures that same kind of cutting. Now, these tongs aren't quite big enough for 8mm rope. So it's going to fail, and it's going to fail consistently on all of those. That's a design feature. I don't consider that. That doesn't make the shears bad. It just means that, or the cutters bad. It just means that you can't use these with a large diameter rope. And am steel fails magnificently. I think, am steel is some tough stuff. Second time, third time. It's not going to cut am steel. You should not use it with am steel. So for something like this, and it's got it up in these blades, it performs better than you would think. These cross blades, like even if the fibers go through between the blades, it's still up against two blades. So it's going to cut. It works pretty good. It's just a large handle. I'll talk more about that kind of stuff as we go. The Ontario takes a different design. I like the handle a lot better, but the blades are actually cut so that they move into each other and then go like this. So there's a straight line between them. I've found that I have problems with that. Cotton, already got the problem. So it cuts through and then it gets down to a few fibers and then it gets stuck between the blades. It does go through if I pull hard enough. Not on nylon, so it failed the nylon. Second time through it does. And it sucks because it's such a nice handle. It feels great in the hand. It's not, it might be big enough to cut that. It is. The opening is big enough, unlike the jackknife, to cut larger diameter. But boy, it has a hard time on it because of that same problem. It's the fibers are just getting stuck down at the base. Gotta stop the test there. I expected it to perform better already. So it's mostly a fail. I wouldn't recommend this knife, despite the fact that it has a lot of good things about it. Trilobite Easy Cut is a very affordable option. I'll just show it. I think I've actually used one side of this. So show a fresh blade. Good on the cotton. Whoops. Good on the nylon. We can try nylon without holding it. It still cuts even if you don't hold it. And that goes, so for nylon, that puts it at a fairly substantial rope where you don't even need tension on it. It cuts through the smaller diameter. Let's see, what would be next? Hemp. 8mm hemp. 8mm posh. I don't think it's going to be big enough. It's not going to be able to cut regatta braid. It's not big enough. And then am steel, I doubt it will cut. Oops, am slushy split. Let's try that again. Does not. Second time, it does cut am steel. That was one of the best performing am steels I've seen. I haven't tested this knife, despite the fact that it has reusable blades, and I have tested this one more. I haven't tested it on am steel a lot. Easy knife is the one that is, and I should say, this is easier to cut than these two and this one. It requires, this one's pretty sharp actually. This requires very little effort to cut through. And so moving on, we have two more. These are a little bit different than the other draggers. These are more of a knife or a blade. These hooks are just different. You're pushing it up into the hook. There's a little bit of a rocking motion that you can do. You can rock it. But mostly you're just wedging it in and pulling it straight to make the cut. Just to talk about the differences, that Benchmade is a single bevel. It's flat on one side. It's got a bevel on the other. The Boker is beveled on both sides. So fundamentally, the Boker is going to be sharper. I'm going to go ahead and give it to that. Large handle, small handle. This folds. It's been so long, I don't remember how the folding mechanism works. It's this. Pull it up. Folds very compact. This has a lifetime sharpening warranty. You can send this into Benchmade. They'll sharpen it for free every time. Really nice feature. We're going to autofocus that and lock that. There we go. Hopefully that stays in focus now. So let's do the Boker, or the Benchmade. Cotton. These, the way they're designed, they fundamentally require some force. Just can't really get around that. That's kind of the negative to them. Because if you got somebody who's under tension from the rope being too tight, that means the next step is to cut them, or to pull really hard. Not sure why it's doing so difficult on having such a hard time on that hemp. I haven't tested these extensively. I kind of expected better than that. If you do a jerking motion, it works better. There is the posh. Do it like that. I think I'm getting a little bit more of the hang of it. Kevlar, will it cut this? It might cut regatta braid. It takes a lot of force, but it is cutting. With a lot of rocking, it cuts. And Amsteel, I don't know if it'll cut this. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna work. Amsteel is tough. It's not even halfway cut through, so it's gonna fail the Amsteel test. Boker Risco. Much easier. Still more work than I want, but it does cut. Hemp. Ooh, it just really went into that hemp. It got caught at the end, but the first part was really good. Actually, really fatiguing after a while. Let's do Kevlar. Okay. I actually just cut myself on the little serrated part. It does cut the Kevlar. Definitely cut myself. Trying to get that out. One of the disadvantages, this has that serrated part so close. You might want to consider dulling it. So, that just happened. God, I don't even feel like doing the regatta braid. Well, I guess since the Boker did it, or the Benchmade did it. Actually, that serrated blade portion is going to be better for it than the actual blade. Can't really explain why. There's some cases where the Boker appears to do just better, and there are some cases where the Benchmade just seems to do better. It may actually be that it's dulling, that the bevel is dulling. Given that it's a double bevel, the other disadvantage of the boker is going to be that it dulls quicker. So the bench, and I actually think the benchmate is made of slightly stronger steel, or harder steel anyway. I'm just having a really hard time with that. It feels like it's gotten duller. Although the benchmate failed that test as well. One of those ropes really dulled it out. It's not cutting cotton as well either. It's not like me, is it? Cut it with the other hand. No, it has actually gotten duller. So this one actually just dulled in the course of the test. Not thrilled about that. Yeah. Where are we at? Should I split it to a different video? I'm at 20 minutes in, so I kind of. Let's go ahead and summarize it briefly here. When I look at what this kind of tells me, it tells me that although they are popular, both of these tools are inferior to tools that use blades. That smooth cutting on the blade requires you to put less stress on somebody who's probably already under too much tension and maybe having like paresthesia or some other kind of symptom related to bondage. And frankly, these blades are just replaceable. So it takes more pressure. The kind of mechanism fundamentally requires you to put a different kind of motion, which I think is a little bit problematic. That famous old Gerber, I can understand why it was famous. The Gerber Easy Cutter, Easy Knife, whatever it was called, was popular because it was dirt cheap, used a replaceable utility blade, and it cut very well. This still cuts very well. Wow, I'm actually gonna have to patch the blood up. This still cuts really well, but because of that gap right here, you have to be really careful about the way that you cut. And this new version is just a very kind of large tool. The case for it's ridiculous. It's like a half moon shape. So I'm really not super thrilled about it, despite the fact that the old one looked like it was a pretty cool toy. Class shears were, I still think they're a great idea if you're buying for a classroom and you need some spares just to give out and lend out. The three line cutters, the Ontarios just failed. I can disqualify them. They're not viable safety cutters. The two remaining, the jackknife, I think I like less because it's very large. The trilobite is actually, I'm just going to go out and say it's my favorite cutter now. And I'm going to talk more about why it is, but essentially, this requires almost no tension on any common rope type. It can cut every rope type. I guess it can even can't cut him still pretty well. And it has the potential to cut a lot of lines all in one swipe, whereas a safety cutter doesn't. So there's various things kind of going on. I'm going to do a final video to kind of summarize that. I highly recommend this. This is replaceable blades. It's, I think, $20, maybe 25. It's more affordable than these other options. And it actually cuts, in most practical purposes, better. The one exception being with suspension bondage, I think shears take on a little bit more of a. Let's go ahead and reverse this out now. I think that shears take on a little bit more of a usefulness with suspension. Among these two shears, for $30, $35, these cut extremely well. They've been used a lot. I've certainly used them more than the two test cuts. They cut anything except AMSteel. Regatta braid is one more that they take, well, specifically that half inch rope it can kind of struggle with, but I kind of expect that. The Kretzer Safety Boy Robins are huge. They weigh way too much. I've talked in another video about why it kind of sucks. You have to get the blade so far back. They have a lot of bandage cutting blade that you're not going to use because you're cutting a rope, not bandage. So they're kind of problematic, but if you're teaching a class and you don't know what other people are going to be using, if you bring these along, you know that you'll be able to cut it, which is the one thing I really like about these. I'll definitely be using them. Some final takeaways from the safety cutter test. I have found that all of my tools have been dulled at least a little bit in the course of the safety cutter test. My main kind of takeaway from that is that rope types such as Amsteel, such as Kevlar, I think they're just probably pretty destructive to rope cutters, and that there may not be anything that we can do about that. Even my Kretzer safety boy Robbins, comparing some earlier videos that I have prior to cutting Amsteel multiple times, I think that they perform a little bit better earlier on. The popularity, I think, of like the Benchmade and the Boker, those hook cutters, maybe in due in part to the fact that they're largely tested on jute and hemp, especially because that's where they're going to cut the best, and then maybe nylon, which is certainly within their area of ability, as opposed to those higher cutting, higher tech ropes where they show to be less competitive cutters. I think that their area of kind of best suitedness is also with suspension, with like a weighted suspension line where you can slash it under tension and under a great amount of tension, because that's where they're going to perform the best. So I don't think they're quite as versatile as a utility blade cutter, as a razor blade cutter, or something with a knife-like cutting edge and a guard to protect people. I don't think they're just as versatile as those. However, I do kind of want to recommend them. They're still going to be in my top five. Because I think under their kind of ideal circumstance, they're still very good tools, and that they could be very good backup tools. Hope the safety cutter test was helpful to you. If you would like to leave a comment about any individual tool or any other questions, please feel welcome to. I'll try to get to them. Thank you so much.